Good morning, students. Today we are discussing about what is the relationship between focal length and radius of curvature. First of all, we know the focal length. Already we know in last classes, this is a spherical segment or spherical mirror. So this is the pole of the mirror. So this is principal focus. This is center of curvature. What is the focal length? We know that the distance between pole of the mirror and the principal focus is known as focal length, which is denoted by F. So the radius of curvature nothing but the distance between center of curvature and pole of the mirror is known as radius of curvature. So which is denoted by R. We observed here the radius of curvature is equals to two types of focal length. Generally we observe here, but present we derive the relation between focal length and the radius of curvature. Present relation between focal length and radius of curvature. So this is the mirror, principal axis, this is the pole of the mirror. A light ray is incident parallel to the principal axis. Here the light ray is OM. Here the light ray O is parallel to the principal axis and incident at M on the surface of the mirror. It is reflected along the, it will be reflected along MF. So this is reflected ray. So this is incident light or incident ray. So here we draw the, at point of incident we draw the normal also. So how here we draw the normal to determine the angle of incidence and angle of reflection. So here CM is nothing but perpendicular which is drawn from M. Here OM is incident light, MF is reflected light. So CM is normal. Initially the light ray incident parallel to the principal axis along OM, it's reflected along MF. At point of incidence, we draw the normal along CM. Here CM is normal, OM is incident light and MF is reflected ray. So here angle made by the incident light at M is theta. Angle made by the reflected ray is 2 theta. Here also angle theta, here also theta. Here angle OMC equals to theta. Angle MFP equals to 2 theta. Present we draw the normal from M to the principal axis, that is D. Here MD is, we draw the normal from principal, from M on principal axis, that is MD. Here MD is a normal. Here D and P, the distance between D and P is very negligible. So D nothing but P, P nothing but also D, we are considered here. So we draw the normal to the principal axis, that is MD. So angle MFD is also here considered as 2 theta. Why? Because P is, the distance between P and D is very negligible. So that's why angle MFP equals to 2 theta. Similarly angle MFD is also 2 theta. So present from law of reflection. Law of reflection. We know that what is law of reflections? we are, the first law of reflection is nothing but incident light and reflected ray and normal are lies in same plane, and second one is angle of incidence is equals to angle of reflection. Here angle of incidence is theta, angle of reflection is 2 theta. Here theta equals to, we show that theta is equals to 2 theta. So here angle MOC from triangle OMC and triangle CMD is are similar. Similarly, triangle CMD, CMD angle is also theta. Here tan theta equals to, tan theta equals to MD by CD. Similarly, from triangle MFD, tan 2 theta equals to, 2 theta is equals to MD by FD. MD by FD. But here the angles are very small. That's why tan theta equals to theta. Similarly, tan 2 theta becomes to also 2 theta. So angles are very small. Angles are very small, hence tan theta equals to theta, that equals to MD by CD. Similarly, tan 2 theta equals to 2 theta, that equals to MD by FD. Let us consider this is equation 1, this is equation 2. In above equation, the equation 1 is substitute in equation 1. Substitute in equation 1. So equation 2. Then equation 2 implies 2 theta 2. But theta from equation 1, what is that? MD by CD. So here MD by FD, MD MD cancel. So CD, CD nothing but the distance between center of curvature and D nothing but pole of the mirror. The distance between pole of the mirror and center of curvature is radius of curvature, which is denoted by R. But here CD nothing but R. Similarly, FD nothing but the distance between principal focus and pole of the mirror is known as focal length, which is denoted by F. The distance between FD or FP, which is denoted by F. So these values are substituted in above expression. 2 by CD nothing but R, 1 by F. Therefore, do the cross multiplication. R is equals to 2F. Therefore, the radius of curvature is equals to 2 times of focal length. So similarly, F is also R by 2. Focal length is always equals to half of its radius of curvature. This is the relation between focal length and the radius of curvature. So listen once again. Initially, the light ray which is parallel to the principal axis is incident along OM. It's reflected along MF. Here point of incident we draw the normal, here normal is CM. So due to this normal, we are determined the angle of reflection and angle of incidence. Angle of incidence is theta, angle of reflection is 2 theta. From the law of reflection, angle of incidence is always equals to angle of reflection. Hence, from triangle CMD, tan theta equals to MD by CD. Similarly, from triangle MFD, tan 2 theta equals to md by fd. Here angles are very small, hence tan theta becomes 2 theta, that equals to md by cd. Let us consider equation 1, tan 2 theta is equals to 2 theta md by fd, that equals to equation 2. Equation 1 is substitute in equation 1, finally we can get 2 of md by cd is equals to md by fd, both terms are cancelled. CD nothing but the distance between radius of curvature and pole of the mirror is known as radius of curvature. The distance between principal focus and pole of the mirror is focal length, which is denoted by f. Substitute the values in the above expression, finally we can get r is equals to 2f, f is equals to r by 2. This is the relationship between focal length and radius of curvature.